Okay. The task at the end of the last lecture was to figure out what the G-term cell is doing. I've shown you a picture of this thing here. And I just mentioned that the big advantage of such a G-term cell is the high frequency range, gigahertz range. For example, this DSAC 250 G-term cell goes up to about 18 gigahertz. And the task was to think at home, what is this thing doing? Well, it's also measuring the radiated electromagnetic emission, as we discussed last time. But why is this thing going up to higher frequency ranges while the standard DEM cell is just going up to 1 gigahertz, 2 gigahertz, or maybe 3 gigahertz, depending on how it's constructed? Any idea why this is better in the frequency range? Or how this might be constructed, this thing?
Shape.
The shape is definitely different, yeah. The shape of the, well, let's draw it a little bit. The shape of the DEM cell as we've discussed last time looks like this. So we have here connector. Usually it's an N connector, it's a navy connector. This is somehow the shape of the G-term cell. There is another connector. Here we are connecting the coaxial cable directly to the input of the EMI receiver. And the inner wire of the coaxial cable will be then transferred into this metal plate, the septum. And here the inner wire, or the metal plate, is terminated. Last time we've seen in the picture a very big ...50-ohm resistor. So to match the whole measurement setup to the 50-ohm system. Okay, remember we said that a special printed circuit board is needed, which is placed here on this opening. And then at the bottom side of the printed circuit board, we have our IC under test that is facing into the G-term cell. Into the DEM cell. Okay, so the G-term cell looks a little bit different. So we also have a connector. But the shape, as I said, in this case looks like this. So it only has more or less the first part of the G-term, of the DEM cell. And the remaining part here is not present anymore. What was the drawback of this geometry that we mentioned last time? I said that later on in the lab, you can do then some experiments with the DEM cell, and you can take a look into the DEM cell a little bit, and you will see that somewhere, for example, here at the corners, there are ferrites located, maybe also here somewhere at the corner. So on special places, there are some damping elements, and also the shape of the septum is sometimes also very often done in a very special way that, like this. So that all over the range from here, here we have 50 ohm coaxial cable, a 50 ohm connector, so that all over the range here we should have a 50 ohm system as close to 50 ohm as possible. And as the septum is widening up here and going narrow there to match the 50 ohm, we also have to align the, in this case, all the capacitive couplings and the stray couplings are in a right way. Not just the capacitive, also the inductive coupling and everything. So that there are not so many reflections within the DEM cell so that we can measure up to a certain frequency range. Okay, well, basically here we have more or less the same problem. The only thing, the only difference is that septum Most probably it looks like this. So from the top view, you can also draw it. The septum somehow mainly looks like this. So it's widening up. And here at the end of the septum, it is terminated by a whole bunch of resistors, which are in total providing a total impedance of 50 ohm. And there it's directly connected to the chassis of the GTEM cell, and then the chassis is connected to the shield of the coaxial cable. Okay, so this is one part of the termination. So here we really have a 50 ohm resistor. And the other part of the termination is provided by additional absorbing pyramid. Maybe you've seen a typical EMC test chamber, an anechoic chamber, for example, where we also have these absorbers on the corners and then on the walls. So there in the GTEM cell, we also have these absorbers at the end of the. So to totally absorb all these electromagnetic waves that are then propagating from our device on a test, which is also mounted on a printed circuit board. We have here our device on a test, which is also then phasing into the GTEM cell. And the location here is from the distance from the chip to the septum, more or less the same as it is here. Well, it's not really drawn in there, right? But just to give you an idea. Okay, so yeah, what's now the big benefit of such a GTEM cell compared to the DEM cell? I would not say no reflections, but not that many reflections, at least not up to 18 gigahertz, or at least to the frequency where the GTEM cell is specified. Because here, at all the edges and the corners, we have mismatches and reflections, and this is not that dominant here in the GTEM cell. So this is the big advantage, that it goes up into a higher frequency range because there are not so many reflections.